Ja, thank you for the nice introduction. And we heard nice talk from Lion, and then we are talking about another Gen Cat links. Lippy links is a tool we developed to link the Lippy identification to more further system level analysis. And in this tutorial, I will show you why we developed this tool and where you can use it and how to use it. During this several days talk, you heard lots of names about lipids. And then when you are reading papers, you sometimes figure out there are different names for lipids. For example, these are kind of common ones. And then people write in brackets a four-letter code. You can also find these names in common databases and also with other different abbreviation names. And this four-letter codes are coming from the two fatty acids and the phospholipids classes as an abbreviation. But it's a little bit misleading because there are some very similar names, and then it's very difficult to find a possible proper way to name them. So a shorthand name with both class names, the number of the carbons, number of double bonds for each fatty acids are crucial, yeah, for the comparison and to share of the data. And then we want to further annotate the position of the double bonds. We also need additional information. And this is the ideal case, but in the real world, we are speaking different languages, and we also have different understanding of how to make a proper notation for this lipids. So that's why we need some standards. So Gerhard has published the shorthand notation and it has been updated last year for more situations. So according to this definition and his tutorial also, we have this bulk level structures. And then it's written just the lipid classes and the sum of carbon numbers, sum of double bonds. And then if we go further, there can be different fatty acid residues. In this level, we don't know where the position of each fatty acid, but at least we know there are two types. And then we come to the fatty acyl position level. Then we know this one is on the SN1, this one is on the SN2 and vice versa. And then in the databases and many other biological pathways, then you see we need the exact positions of the double bond and also the cis and trans information and whether they are omega-3 fatty acids or omega-6 fatty acids because they are going to the different pathways. And when we are using the high throughput mass spec-based lipidomic workflow, usually we are reporting lipids in this either bulk structure or discrete structure level. And there's a huge gap between what we can report confidently and what is in the biological meaning. And then if we have the names in this, we still can probably find some way to connect to the pathway level. And this is an ideal case. We have the standards. If everybody agreed to use it, it would be great. But the real world is we collect 17 different lipid softwares and from 5 databases for one single lipid structure. We have so many different versions. Some of them are just slightly different, sometimes write O2 or 2O or with and without brackets, or some additional flavors. So this brings us a lot of problems to unite and cross-linking the reports from different publications and results. Additionally, if we go further to the network or metabolic network or pathways, sometimes they are also using different abbreviation systems. And then they are using also probably not linked to the lipid maps yet, but this due to historical reasons, and we need to somehow unite or pass our lipidomic identifications to this kind of network for further analysis. So you may already see this kind of ideas in several ways. So we found the sample preparation all the way, pass the instrument analysis, analyze the data, and somehow we plot here. Because we are talking slightly different languages, we cannot easily transfer our data to the existing knowledge base or pathways. If we can do it, then we can simulate based on these advanced networks and then confirm our hypothesis or find other observations. So we develop lipid links, helping us to transfer our observations or lipid identifiers from MS-based lipidomics to the networks. This is the interface of the software. We can use it in two different versions. One is the desktop version, is the full functional one. So you have to make a small installation and then you can do lots of tasks. You can install on your own lab, find a powerful computer to make a in-house server. You have access to the source code. You can have the EXE version and you can even change or edit own customized input output styles. And kindly provided by LipidMaps, we also have the web service of LipidLinks running on LipidMaps website. You don't need to make any installation. You just open the browser and you can do some live tasks. And we'll show you how it works later, mainly based on the lipid links on LipidMaps website. So the idea of this software is we collect all common abbreviation names from different softwares, and then we're trying to process with it. So you can get your identification list from different softwares, or you search the different lipid databases and you get interest of a list of lipid names, or you collect some interest lipids from the publication literature, or you just write some common abbreviations from your research. And then we have three major functions. One is called converter, just to convert different names from one to common ones, for example, from software to shorthand annotations. And then we can export also for some other tools, for example, LibCreator or LibTiger. And you can customize this input and output formats if you are using the desktop version and have some programming skills. And then we have the equalizer function, which you can decode the abbreviation and then compare the different data sets. Some of them are reported in the bulk, some are reported in the with fatty acid information. No problem, you can use this equalizer to cross compare them. And you can also control if you over report your identifications. For example, you report so many double bond position isomers of lipids from your MS data. We recommend you to equalize it to a more proper level. Another main function is called linker that we use whatever lipid abbreviation you get from your resources, your styles, to different resources. This including the Lion ontology, which presented in the previous talk, and other pathway analysis. This includes also BioPan, which Caroline will show you in the later tutorials, and other network integration using the accession IDs, for example, KB IDs, and other reactions like RIA or Uniprot IDs. So the first module is called Converter. We collect different tools and databases, and then we can export to five different styles. For example, this is a different abbreviation styles we collected, and then they are in different information levels. And then we can convert them to the shorthand notation and some other styles also within the LibriLinks support. And then you can convert them to the style you need and then connect to other tools, for example, if you're Tiger or BioPan. And then we have the equalizer function. In this function, we can convert, so cross compare them. For example, this one is with the double bound information. This one is without, but we can basically say this one is comparable with this one. Then we can say this is with SN1, SN2 position information. This is without. So we can say this one can be compared with this one. And this is the sum composition of the carbon number and double bond. And this is the subspecies of this one. So based on this hierarchical tree, we can equalize them together and make cross validation of different data sets. This is a more detailed example. So if you analyze your results by two different software tools, you get a different style of the annotations or identifiers. You collect some information from one references written in the text representations, and then you find some interest lipids from the databases. And then you submit to the equalizer tool, and then you get this table. In this equalizer tool, we equalize it to the bulk level with brackets. This is just for the software friendly style. This one you can still copy it and use the converter to convert to the standard shorthand format. And then you can see the 2-1 report, something which is also found in the database. Or the sphingomyelins here, which identified by both software, are found in the references and also in the database. Although the names are slightly different, but it's you can equalize to the same precursor. The third tool is called Linker. In Linker, we solve the problems. Let's say when you search this POPC in all these different databases, you only get reports from HMDB and PubChem. You get some not so relevant results from UniProt KB, but these are again just limited number of information. In LibriLinks, we provide you option, just you put POPC here, you just press search, and then you get converted to shorthand notation, BioPan notation, and accession IDs and links to different databases. For this, we covered all of these databases using just POPC, this simplified identifier. So we can connect the abbreviations to all these different kinds of resources. How to get it? So you search on Google LibriLinks, and then you get four major links. The first one is the source code on GitHub. So you can also download the exe package from it. And then you get our open access publication. And then you can visit LibriLinks from the LibriMaps website. And there's a quick start user guide step-by-step on the same website as well. If you go to GitHub using the first link, you can go here for download. And if you meet any issues or you want some bugs, report on bugs, you click here to submit some feedback to us. So you click here, release, and there are two releases. You go to the most recent release, and then you click this link, you download the zip file, you just unzip it. There's only one exe folder. You just click on it, and then it will start to run. a much easier version is just you go to this link on Little Maps, and then you'll start the browser, and then you can start to use it directly without registration. Yeah, here I record some video tutorial for you to see how it will work. Let's see if it's running. Okay. Here you click on the link. It will start on Little Maps website. You can see three major modules with descriptions. Here you click on the converter. Here are some templates for you. You can say which level you want and the different output. Here we select shorthand notation, and then you start to convert. And if you wait a little bit, the conversion will finish, and then you can review it on the website. And then you can also click to download results as an Excel table. You open this table in Excel, and then yeah, you get the original name and then the converted name. And then you can also submit a file to Lippy Link's website to convert. So again, we go to converter. Here is a tab called convert file. You can select the file. We prepare an example template for you. You can download this CSV template. In this template, you can collect from different sources. So each column standing from a data source or publication or a different identification from the software. You just upload this file to the website. Just select the file and upload. And then you select the export style you want. And then you just click convert file. Then Lippy Link will convert it for you. And then each column will be treated separately, as you can see here. And then you can download the output as an Excel table. In this Excel table, you have the original column and the same converted names in the column next to it. So this is basically how converter is working. And then you can go, you can test the equalizer, you can click the link here on the top, or go back to the front page and click equalizer. We have prepared you a template here. Just download the template. You can open this template. We have a sample, which, and then two other reference data sets. And then you just upload this one to the website. You select this template. And then you can decide whether you want to compare them in the bulk level or the molecular species level with detailed residue information. And then click run and wait a little bit. And then you will see the results. In this result, you will see it's shown in the previous slide. So you see they are equalized to this bulk level. And then you can see the sample is matching to different references. For example, reference two, you don't have fatty acids. And then in the reference one, you don't have this lipid. And then some things are not matched. And then it will be listed later. Then you can download it as an Excel table. You'll see the same table organized here for in the Excel. For it stands for the matched ones. And you will see these ones are matched. then the unmatched ones, and you can also have a look of the matches in the molecular species level. Okay. It's like, yeah. Okay, these are basically the tutorials for the converter and equalizer. I hope you get the idea how it works and what you can do with it. You can also generate by such VM plot. And then we can go to see how the linker is working. We have a very fast shortcut here. Like you are searching something, just type the names here and click here the check resources. And then you get very fast check of one lipid. So here you can see we have different subcategories of database or resources. And then you can go through all of them, including reactions and related like UniProt KB. And yeah, we can look some of them. For example, we click on PPMaps link. It will guide you to PPMaps website. The double bond position is the same. And then we can also go to, let's say, PubChem. PubChem here. And then it will guide you to the PubChem website. And then you can use the PubChem ecosystem or the KEG pathways. Then open the KEG pathway website and you can check related pathways. And then there's real reactions. You can see the reactions from phospholipids to lysophospholipids here. And then you can also link to UniProt KB. So this is the protein names and organism species. And then you can click here to get the enzymes corresponding to the reaction. So this is one fast overview of how the fast search will work, and then we can go, sorry, my fault. Yeah, there's sometimes the database will update and some of these links may not working. That's why we have the identifier number here. For example, for Lion, we recently figured out these links have some issues, but no problem, you can copy this identifier. And then you go to the Lion website, this ontology page. It's different from the Lion web, but it shows you the ontology. You just delete the unworking part and then go to this classes. Click here, and then you paste this identifier, and you'll find this lipid. And it will show you the lipid ontology information from the Lion ontology. And you can also run a list of abbreviations. So just simple paste one list in the interface. And then you can convert them in the internal names. And then you can also check, for example, PLP, what is that? And to different databases. You can download the results as an Excel table. Yeah, you can see their names converted to other names. Identifiers, for example, KB, HMDB, PubChem, and for RIA and other Swiss probes, you have different lots of names, then you are all stored in one cell and the links to the databases. You can also upload one file, and we have a template for you as well. You just prepare this template. You can also collect from different resources, data sets, publications, in one Excel table. Just upload this file. We have to wait until it uploads. The file name will be listed here and then you can click submit file, and then it will start to find all possible links, resources to it. And then you can download the output file. In this output file, each column in the original template will be stored in a separate tab, and all the information will be still collected in one page, yeah, including the identifiers and then corresponding links to each database. Okay. I hope you understand how the three main modules are working, and then we can have a more complex task to have a look. So we collect from three publications, reporting lipid identifications from human plasma. So paper one has 350 lipids, paper two has around 280, paper three has over 400, and they report in different abbreviation styles, different information levels, different styles as well. And then we can see, let's see how we can do with it. Let's say if you want to compare the three data sets. In the past, probably you will have the knowledge what is what, and then you compare in one Excel. But you can do it now with lipid links equalizer and then find the common ones. For example, between the TGs and the bulky ones, then you don't need to calculate them one by one. For this, we recommend you to use the desktop version, because this over 1,000 lipids is a bit heavy for Lipid Maps website. And please do it on your own computer or lab servers. So you download the pack, you click on the .exe file, which will pop up this window just to monitor everything. It will open a browser. It looks almost exactly the same like on the Lipid Maps. You click on equalizer and you come to this. And then this is the Excel table I prepared. I just collect the names from the supplements from all the three papers without editing it. Just put them in three different columns. And then you upload this file. And because most two other columns are only have the bulk level, so we equalize only in the bulk level. So, and then you run the equalizer. And then when you run equalizer from your own computer or the lab, you can monitor what is going on, and then wait for some time, and then it will finish, and it will perfectly align them together. As we can see here, it's showing 10 out of 214 entries. So that means from this over 300 lipids, 214 lipids are actually reported at least by two resources. And then you can plot such like VM plot and some other plots to show the common lipids. And then you can see some ones are only identified in one of the resources. And then you can download it as a Excel table. Yep, and now you can see the results. So again, the first column is the bulk level information. And then you can see the matched ones and unmatched ones. And some ones are not currently supported, or it will be in the skip level. And then, yeah. And now we can see if we can find the resources, like from all database links and so on. So we just go to link, upload this file, and then you have to wait for some time. And when you run from your own computer, you can also switch back to the previous tabs before you close it. And then you can also monitor what is going on, if the program is still working. And then when the program finishes, you will get the links to all these abbreviations. Some of them we don't find from the databases. Some of them we find more information from it. And then you can get all results in one Excel table. So when you open it, you can see here the converted names and then different identifiers and all these links. They are all here in one Excel table. And you can see some of them has more.
Yeah, we lost you.
More information about the databases, some has less information. Is it back?
Yes, you're back.
Yeah, I said my internet connection is unstable. Okay. I hope you at least saw from here. So we can see from the, you can see the results of each publication results in one separate tab. And then you can see some of the lipids actually have not so many identifiers, only in some databases. Some are in more databases and more information. And this applies to all three columns which you submitted. And then you get them all in one table. And then one thing I have to mention is like, because you submit your lipids without double bond position. So lipid links can find all possible links from the databases, for example, lipid maps. There are so many isomers. We can have a look of three just to show you the diversity of the double bond positions. Like you have a double bond here even, and then you can have like this. But these are not all the same in different databases. Some databases we have more, some we have less. For example, you go to the Keck pathway, it only shows you the standard arachidonic acid structure. But we have all this information stored in this Excel table. Yeah, for example, you click here, you can see all the HMPP IDs are stored here. And then you click on the lipid maps, then you get lipid maps, all possible IDs of this double bond positional isomer. And then this brings you lots of possibilities. And then it's very a huge task if you want to do it manually, but if you use lipid links, you can just run it and all the information will be collected and stored here and in an organized way. Yeah. For example, all these IDs, or you want to even visit all the links here are all stored here. Okay, these are the video tutorial part. And then we are still working on it. So later today, Caroline will show you BioPan, and then we are very proud that we collaborate with BioPan to integrate lipid links into BioPan to help you to cover some names. And then we are working on lipid links to LPP Tiger tool to use lipid links to cover some names as well. And we are working on better connection to resources, for example, Lion, and we need to fix these links issues. I already find out how to solve that, and we'll fix in the later releases. And we are working also with the EcoStar team, trying to help to build a lipid links interface to it help to convert names into the shorthand standard annotations. And there are more possibilities, of course, and we want to link lipidomics tools and resources in another level as well. And then if our community or users have more ideas and want to contribute to the project and support, we are welcome. It's really a challenging task to maintain all these different software and database styles. And we need also help from the community to report what is working and then what styles you need and so on. For this, you can go to the GitHub and then you can submit issues. You can see some people want to use it through Python directly, and then some people report some linker issues, and then these are solved ones. Some ones were still pending, but you can welcome to support us or give us feedback. This morning, we also received some feedbacks or discussions in this discussion area. So if you have some new ideas or you want to ask some questions, you can submit some your questions here as well. So this is the end of my part. This work is not possible without the support from our nice team and my supervisor, Maria Federer. And we are also very thankful that Lipid Maps is kindly providing a service for Lipid Links on their website. And then for any updates, you can follow our Twitter or GitHub, and our some other softwares are here as well. Thank you for your attention, and I'm ready for questions.